We were talking about the applications. So what the people do is they estimate time कि एक project complete करने में कितना time लगेगा, how many workers they require, or how many workers can let them complete the task as soon as possible. So there is a variety of application around you where you actually use inverse proportion. You will be doing some practice questions which will actually give you the examples of their application. So let's move towards the working part. So I'm going to refer to you guys to an Orwell mathematics book. That's the Oxford 7th edition book. It's a really very good. I'm going to refer to you guys to a D2 book. We are going to do chapter number 1, inverse proportion chapter from there. This is the investigation part. So here we give an example of a speed and the time taken. So you can see that when we are traveling at 10 km per hour, it takes us 12 hours to reach a destination. If you travel at the speed of 20 km per hour, it takes us 6 hours to reach the destination. If I travel at 30 km per hour, it will take us 4 hours to reach the destination. If I travel at 40 km per hour, it takes me 3 hours to reach the destination. If I travel at 60 km per hour, it takes me 2 hours to reach the destination. If I travel with 120 km per hour, that's the speed, it only takes me 1 hour to reach the destination. So you can see that as the speed increases, my time decreases. You can see that it was increasing this way, but my time is decreasing. So whenever we are given some questions, the first thing we have to do is we have to first recognize what sort of proportion it has. Does the question represent direct proportion or does it represent inverse proportion? So I'm going to show you some examples about it. Back to the question which we just read out. Before people can paint the fence in 3 hours, how long will it take 6 people to paint it? So the first step is we need to first make the column out here. The column which represents the quantities. So my first quantity is basically the people. So you can see that it took 4 people to paint the fence in 3 hours. So 4 people, yahan pe people ke niche aayega, aur 3 hours jo hai time ke niche aayega. So we know the unit of time is hours, so I've just written the unit in the bracket so that I don't have to write it again and again. So the question is, how long will it take 6 people to paint it? So I'm going to write 6 under the people and I have to find out how much time will it take me. So what I have to do is, first step, whenever we have to calculate a value, just look at these steps. You can see it right here. So first thing is you have to write the relation. Second, you have to convert the relation into a cost, into an equation using the constant of proportionality. This means that you will be writing an equation and then you will be calculating the constant of proportionality. Then what you will do is you will put the values and you will get your answers. So let's get back here. So my first step is I need to write the relation. We know that we have people and time here. So I will be representing people with the letter P and time with the letter T. So my first step is I'm going to show the relation. So P, proportionality sign, is inverse to proportion. To show inverse proportion, I'm going to write the second variable as the reciprocal. So 1 upon T. This is my first step. Now my second step is I have to change this into a equation. So how? Let's look here. In place of this proportionality sign, I'm going to put an equal to sign. So P is equal to, when I'm changing this into an equation, I'm having an equal to sign. In place of 1, we're going to have a new term or new term, that's the constant, and T will be here as it is. This constant is the number which will never change. Whenever we are writing an equation, this is not a complete equation. Ye equation ban to gayi hai, lekin hamare paas hamesha ek equation mein kya hota hai, we always have a quotient, or you can say coefficient basically. एक हमारे पास नंबर लाजमी होता है. सो वी सी हियर दैट कॉन्स्टेंट इज़ अ फिक्स नंबर, इट विल नेवर चेंज. सो वट वी हैव टू डू इज वी नीड टू फर्स्ट फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ के हियर. टू फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ के इट इज़ वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट कि हमारे पास एटलीस्ट दो नंबर्स होने चाहिए, पी होना चाहिए और टी होना चाहिए. सो क्या मुझे यहाँ पे गिवन है क्वेश्चन में? येस, आई एम गिवन द वैल्यूज ऑफ पी एंड टी. सो इन प्लेस ऑफ पी आई एम गोइंग टू राइट द वैल्यू ऑफ पी, दैट्स 4. And in place of t, I'm going to write the value of t, that's 3. So here, so my p is basically 4 is equals to k will come here as it is divided by t is 4 people make friends in 3 hours. So 3 is the time period. I need to find the k here. तो k को फाइंड करने के लिए आई हैव टू मूव दिस 3 फ्रॉम दिस साइड टू द अदर साइड. हियर द 3 इज डिवाइडेड, वहां लेके जाएंगे तो क्या हो जाएगा, मल्टीप्लाई हो जाएगा. सो k इज इक्वल्स टू 3 4s are is 12. सो 4 into 3, सो k इज इक्वल्स टू 12. दिस इज नॉट द एंड. अब जो हमारे पास यहाँ पे वैल्यू आ गई है k की, इसको हम लिखेंगे k की जगह पे. इफ़ आई री राइट द इक्वेशन, p यहाँ पे वैसे ही आएगा, लेकिन इन प्लेस ऑफ k आई एम गोइंग टू पुट दिस वैल्यू आउट. सो आई एम गोइंग टू राइट द वैल्यू ऑफ 12 इन प्लेस ऑफ k डिवाइडेड बाय t. सो यू कैन सी दैट p इज हियर एज इट इज, t is here as it is, but in place of k, I have written the value of 12. Up now, this is known as my equation. So here is my second step. Ab mere paas equation aa chuki hai. Now what I can do is, I can put any value in place of p or t, and I can calculate the third value. So over here, I had to find the value of time for 6 people. So what I have to do, what I can do is, my third step is I have to put this value of 6 in place of p. So in place of p I'm going to put the value of 6. So 6 comes in place of p is equals to 12 comes here because it is the constant value divided by t. Mujhe t find karna hai. To find t I have to make it alone. पहले मैं अगर इस t को यहाँ पे लेके आऊँ तो क्या हो जाएगा, 6 multiplied by t is equals to 12. क्योंकि अगर हमें t को अकेला करना है, पहले हमें इस t को यहाँ पे लेके आना होगा. यहाँ पे t डिवाइड हो रहा था, when I bring it over there it gets multiplied. So t into 6 is 60. Now I need to find the value of t, I have to make it alone. So to make it alone, I have to shift this 6 from here to here. यहाँ पे 6 multiply हो रहा था, when I take it there, it gets divided. So t is equals to 12 divided by 6. So 12 divided by 6 is how much? It is equals to 6. So this shows me that if I have 6 people, It takes 2 hours. I just made a mistake. So 12 over 6 gives me actually 2. So it takes 2 hours. For 6 people, it takes 2 hours to make the fence. So I hope everything is clear over here, right? So with 6 people, it will only take 2 hours to make the fence.